Hello people, this is Deepak Pindiala from Made in India Techs. You need to be smart before buying a smartphone. The box which was appearing in front of our eyes was
Oppo F3. Now let's unbox it. Yes, this was the device. Let me take it out. Let me boot this up. Give me some time to boot it up. Let's peel this off.
This was the quick specs of this device. It has a dual SIM which supports VoLTE. It was a MediaTek 1.5 processor octa-core. It loaded with 4 GB of RAM and 64 GB of inbuilt memory. It has a 3200 mAh of battery. It doesn't support quick charge. 5.5-inch Full HD display. It has a dual camera in front, which was 16MP and 80MP and 13MP rear camera. It has memory card support up to 128 GB, which runs on Android 6, which was provided the ColorOS in
Oppo. This was the mobile. It was pretty slim, 7.3 mm. And the weight was 153 grams. Yes, this is the black version, which was loaded with 4 GB of RAM and 64 GB of internal storage. The black is looking pretty good.
Let's check out the camera. There is a camera in front which has dual camera. One was 16MP and was 8MP LED notification. The big has the 16MP and 8MP has wide angle lens. Let's unlock it and look the specs.
The fingerprint was pretty awesome. Yes, the fingerprint was as quick. Let us check out the mobile. The mobile was pretty awesome. Let me show you the settings and about the device.
It runs on Android 6, not on Nougat, which was Android 6 was very old.
In the 54 GB, we have the storage information here. There was 52.4 GB internal space available, but I installed so many apps, so there was 48.7 GB remaining.
Luckily, Oppo provide the OTG connection option to it, so we can connect pen drives, stuff, etc. I already told you that it runs on ColorOS. Yeah, there are some bugs in this OS. I will definitely made a video of the bugs and pros and cons of this mobile. Make sure to subscribe the channel and watch it.
Yes, I also done Antutu benchmark test. Let's check out the storage specifications. It was provided by the MediaTek MT6750 1.51
Pro. This MediaTek processor is mainly meant for the budget phones at the rate of 10K, but at the price point of 20K, it is waste product. Yeah, the graphics speed was also bad, as it was provided by Mali T860. It was very slow in loading the graphics.
Yes, you can check out the device information. 5.5 inch, 400 pixel per inch, Android version 6.
It takes 0 to 100 charging in 1 hour. Yes, it was not a quick charge as mentioned above. It because of the 2 ampere charger which provided by the Oppo company. It supports oak charging, which cuts the supply after the reaching of 100%. This was called switching power supply. Let's check out the Antutu.
The Antutu benchmark test was, the score was 52,000 because it was a MediaTek processor. The first bad thing in this mobile was the MediaTek processor. If you are looking for a mobile in 20,000, I don't recommend this. Yes, the RAM, CPU, 3D. Yes, the graphics. Yeah, the graphics is stucking. You can check out this. It was stucking a lot. I doesn't like this. And the other con was the color OS, which was powered by the Oppo. There are some bugs in it. It need to fix. And please, Oppo, give the update to Nougat surely in time. Yes, this was very bad.
The fingerprint was awesome. It is very quick, as not expected.
Yes, now let's check out the camera. Sorry for the shooting bad conditions as I was shooting by a Sony mobile, a 20MP camera. Yeah, this camera also has a bokeh effect, but it was not that good. Let us see the samples. Good. Let us check out the samples. There was a panorama mode. Yet there is no stabilization, even there is no electronic image stabilization or OIS. Yes, you can check out the bokeh effect. It was not that good because there was no, you can check out this here. The bokeh effect was not good, but yet it was good. Yes, this is the Lotto sunglasses. The sound was good. Yes, let's listen. There was a single speaker, but the sound is pretty good. Let's check out the information provided by the Oppo. Yes, it was Oppo F3 Selfie Expert, a dual camera, one camera for selfie, one camera for group selfie. Yes, it was a 16MP front camera, double view with the other 8MP camera, 13MP rear camera, thinner, lighter, seamless touch. Yes, the touch was good, pretty well, but not that awesome. Dual 4G, 32MAH, color OS. Yes, the color OS, as I mentioned, the color OS, the bugs in it was, if we open the notification bar, by it, if we want to close, it was not there. We have to come from down to up. Yes, there are some other bugs. Yes, the history bar, it was like the iPhone. At the price point of this, at the MediaTek processor, coming to the build quality, there is.
I bought it for 20,000 at local market big store, but the surprising thing was I bought it for 20,000 with the freebies of 4 items. I will surely make a video of the freebies. Stay tuned with us, subscribe to us, like us, connect with us. Also, if you have any doubts, let me know what was your doubts. Okay guys, loving you. Bye. This is Deepak Pindyala signing off.
Yes, this JBL headset was looking awesome. The sound quality also good.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon below.